We're going to stay in the saddle and play for you right here, right now.
Charlie Patton.
The second Charlie Patton tune I learned when I was a little bitty boy, about 15, 16 years old, about that high. And when I was 13, we were on a little visit down in Mississippi with one of our uncles. And my brother, who was already into like kind of collecting records and stuff like that, starts asking our uncle about various legendary musical names and things like that, you know. And he's throwing out a bunch of names at our uncle. My uncle said, no, never heard of that guy. Never heard of this guy, never heard of that guy. Then he threw out a name I'd never heard before, Charlie Patton, right? And all of a sudden, like, I'm perked up like that, you know. It's like, you know how you have a dog and you have that whistle that you blow and can't anybody hear but the dog in his ears. It's just like somebody blew that whistle, right? So Uncle got really excited. He said, yeah, I saw him when I was 10 years old or whatever, you know. So I'd say I'd never heard of him up to that point. So when I got home, I decided to check out who he was, you know. And back in the 20th century, if you didn't have a record, you went to the library and you checked out the record from the library and brought it home. So I get the Charlie Patton record from the library, bring it home, put it on, put the needle in. This is what they're talking about. So I had to put it back on again. And again. Finally, it got to the point where I could hear the music through the scrambled eggs. And I said, oh yeah, now I get it. So I got it, and I went with it like a lot of other youngsters did, like Howlin' Wolf did when he was a kid, like Booker White did when he was a kid. I got a little bit out of it. Play the Pony Blues right now. Baby, wanna be your man, yeah. Baby, and it's so cool.